My name is Malashkevich Georgi. I am going to present to you some results obtained in the field of creation and investigation of new activated glasses with composition close to stoichiometry of huntite like crystals. This research is titled Activated Huntite like Glasses, Achievements and Prospects, and was performed in cooperation among these institutions. Here you can see a diagram of lanthanide 3 plus ions energy status. Their main cross-relaxation interaction, these transitions, and some luminescent transitions, which shown with colored arrows. It is seen that only luminescence of cerium, gadolinium, ytterbium ions, as well as europium and terbium ions, is not subjected to cross-relaxation quenching. Also, for the latter three ions, it is possible their metastable state quenching by cooperative transfer of excitation with summation, as in the case of ytterbium-ytterbium pairs, or the disappearance of the quantum, as in the case of europium-3+ and terbium-3+ ions. As it is known, within the weak coupling, the probability of ion-ion transfer excitations is determined by this formula, where the matrix elements of the interaction Hamiltonian for the electrostatic column multipole interaction is characterized by the inverse power dependence on the square of the elements on the distance between donor and acceptor of excitations. Therefore, the search of matrix that provide a light minimal distance between the donor and the acceptor of excitations is relevant. One of the most promising oxide matrices in this regard are huntite-like crystals, which provide the distance value equal to 5.9 angstrom. Here you can see the scheme of coordination polyhedrons in the crystals. Prevailing content of boron oxide in such crystals assumes high glass forming ability of melt and possibility to obtain transparent glasses possessing identical composition. Objectives. The main aim of our work was a creation of new yttrium alumina borate glasses is composition close to stoichiometry of huntite-like crystals, activated by ions of some F, cerium, samarium, terbium, ytterbium, and their elements, chromium, as well as some mercury-like ions, stibium-3+, and research of their spectral luminescence and structural properties in order to determine these materials possible applications. Here you can see our technology and spectral and laser equipment. It should be noted that synthesis of such glasses occurs in relatively narrow field at temperature close to 1,500 degrees centigrade. For the determination of minimal distance between the ions in glasses, we choose samarium-containing ones. This choice is due to the fact that samarium ions are characterized by effective cross-relaxation interactions, as can be seen from this scheme, and weakly effective migration that can be seen from this spectra for the transition. This is the luminescence spectra of such glasses with concentration of samarium, with this concentration of samarium ions. It is seen that the most intense luminescence band lies at 600 and 680 nanometer. We use this known equation to determine the values of spontaneous transition probabilities, luminescence quantum yield, effective luminescence bandwidth, and peak cross section of the transition. Next slide shows the luminescent decay kinetics of hematite-like glasses, red caps, and the same name crystals, blue caps. The caps were analyzed using the following equation, where W1 is the probability of luminescence quenching due to donor-acceptor interaction in condition of minimal distance between rare S ions. Gamma is the macro parameter of first decay. S is the order of multipolar donor acceptor interaction, and W2 is the probability of energy migration from the activated metastable state. The representation of non-radioactive losses on the double logarithmic scale shows that the slope of linear plots is close to 1 for t less than t asterisk. That correspond to exponential ordered decay. And the final stage of the process has a smaller slope and correspond to disordered quenching, representing the losses at t greater than t asterisk as a function of to the third divided by s power, але не разит at s equal 8. This indicates to the favor or to the favor of a dipole-quadrupole interaction and permits us to determine the macroparameter gamma as a slope of the displayed lattice, as well as to calculate microparameter CDA and R minimum with help of the above formulas. Here you can see the initial stages of luminescence decay kinetics of samarium 3 plus ions and obtained values of the macro and micro parameters. It is seen that minimal distance between lanthanide 3 plus ions in the glasses is a record value for oxide matrices. This slide shows that quantum yield of samarium ions luminescence in the concentration region is essentially higher than for the huntite-like crystals. This effect is achieved due to the larger R minimum and transformation of some part of the polyhedrons into the polyhedrons. Here you can see a photo of luminescence of the glass under light emitting diode excitation in these transitions. This slide present the absorption spectra of undoped and stibium doped undoped this line and stibium doped curve number 2 and stibium energy state and stibium 3 plus ions luminescence, KF3, and stibium 3 plus energy status diagram. It is seen that stibium containing glasses are characterized by an intense ultraviolet absorption in the band number 4. And a wide luminescence band with a half width of more than 300 nanometers. This slide shows the glasses luminescence decay kinetics. It is seen that they all curves are non-exponential, for all recording wavelengths. Codoping of the stibium containing glass with cerium and terbium allows us to realize the processes of luminescence sensitization shown in the inset. And to avoid the appearance of cerium 4 plus ions and formation of cerium 3 plus cerium 4 plus groups absorbing in the visible region due to the reducing ability of stibium. Here you can see absorption spectra of the cadopid glasses at different concentration of the dopants. And their spectra of luminescence, KV1, absorption, KV2, and excitation of luminescence of the glass, KV3, for the glass of this composition. Next slide shows luminescent decay kinetics of cerium 3+ and cerium 3+ and terbium 3+ ions for the glasses. And luminescent decay kinetics of stibium 3+ ions in the glass depending on stibium and terbium concentration. Figure A. And depending on lambda recording, figure B. As well as dependence of integral duration, KV2, and luminescence intensity on the concentration of stibium ions. This slide shows the dependence of terbium 3+ ions luminescence sensitized by cerium and stibium ions, depending on cerium oxide and terbium oxide concentration and different concentration of stibium, as well as excitation spectrum for the thin glass, and dependence of luminescence quantum yield on lambda excitation. Here you can see the photos of the glass under E-beam excitation and ultraviolet irradiation with this wavelength and this wavelength. It should be noted that the glasses demonstrate relatively intense luminescence under X-ray excitation too. Here you can see photo of sample number 3 at weak X-ray excitation. This slide shows light attenuation spectra of the glasses cadopid with terbium for different aniline temperature. It is seen that aniline temperature lower than 740 degrees centigrade does not lead to evident crystallization of the glass, and the hydroxyl ions concentration in the glasses is relatively low. This slide shows absorption, KV1, and luminescence, KeV2 and 3, of Huntite light glasses at these conditions. As well as diagram of ytterbium energy status. Here it should be noted that the cooperative luminescence intensity of the glass is approximately in two order of magnitude less than for ytterbium containing silica gel glass under identical conditions. Based on the absorption and luminescence spectra, with the help of this equation, we have calculated that the radiative lifetime equal to this value. It is seen that the luminescent decay for all concentration of ytterbium are described by the exponential law. Here, the magnitudes of its characteristic times obtained with the use of program Contin and Friedkin's is displayed. This figure shows the dependencies of ytterbium 3 plus ions luminescence quantum yield of ytterbium oxide concentration. And this ions luminescence decay depending on hydroxyl ions concentration and probability of the luminescence not radiative quenching on the hydroxyl ions concentration. It is seen that full dehydroxylation of the glass, each luminescent decay time close to the radiative time. This slide shows spectra of the gain cross section for the glass number 2 at different values of fraction of ytterbium ions in the metastable level. It is seen that the appearance of stimulated radiation in the glass for low selective resonator may be expected at 1030 nanometer. Here are tabulated a number of laser parameters of ytterbium containing Huntite light glasses. And for comparison, the same name crystal and the scheme of the experimental setup. It is seen the value of stimulated emission cross section for the glass conceals to the same name parameter of the crystal. However, essentially greater delta lambda for the glass makes the glass promising for generation of ultra-short laser pulses. This slide shows generation radiation spectra and this pumping power. And dependence of generated radiation at pumping power. Relatively high threshold of unabsorbed power is caused by the coefficient of non-active losses of about 0.01 inverse centimeter due to the presence of microinclusion of platinum. At use of chromium yttrialuminium gannate crystals at saturable absorber with initial transmission of 95%, permits us to realize Q-switched lasing with monopulse half-width of about 80 nanoseconds. In addition, we synthesized a number of similar glasses cadoped with cerium and ytterbium with this composition. Chromium and ytterbium is this composition. Here you can see absorption and luminescence spectra of the glasses. As it is known, luminescence of chromium 3 plus in glasses is subjected to effective temperature quenching. Cadoping of the chromium containing glasses with ytterbium, judging from this slide, permits us to decrease the quenching compare curves 6 and 20 or 4 and 23. This slide shows the composition of the luminescence and luminescence excitation spectra in two individual components. This band are caused perhaps by formation of chromium 5 plus in the glasses. It should be noted that the presence of 5 charged chromium ions was confirmed by the results of electron paramagnetic resonance study. Using this decomposition, we calculated Rachau parameters under the assumption that the most all intense individual bands are caused by chromium 3 plus ions. The results are tabulated here. This slide shows luminescent decay kinetics of chromium 3 plus ions and ytterbium 3 plus ions. It is seen that cadopin of chromium ions, chromium containing glasses with ytterbium leads to essential acceleration of chromium luminescent decay. Kev, compare Kev 1 with Kev 4. It testifies to transfer of excitation from chromium 3 plus to ytterbium 3 plus ions. At last, this slide shows dependence of quantum yield of luminescence of chromium and chromium ytterbium containing glasses on excitation wavelengths. These curves were obtained using the absolute method. And these curves were calculated using the formula. It is seen that the value of quantum yield of luminescence of the cadopin glasses are relatively significant. That permits us to propose the glasses as luminescence concentrator for solar cell. It should be noted that the complicated dependence of the quantum yield on wavelengths lambda is caused by presence of chromium 3 plus and chromium 4 plus and chromium 6 plus, which play role of interfilters in the glasses. Conclusions. Glasses of the system this composition near stoichiometry of the Hantite-like crystals are characterized by the minimum distance between lanthanide ions close to 6.7 angstrom, a record for oxide matrices, and permits to introduce into them lanthanides concentration up to 4.5 multiplied by 10 to the 21 power ions per cubic centimeter. Due to the large minimum distance and partial transition of the polyhedrons to the polyhedrons, the quantum yield of active dopant luminescence in the glasses in the region of the dopant medium concentration is higher than the Hantite-like crystals. It permits us to recommend such glasses as promising active laser materials. Peculiarly, samarium and ytterbium doped Hantite-like glasses may be used as active materials of fiber laser operating at lambda close to 600 and 650 nanometer and ultra-short pulse generated microchip laser, respectively. Notable that this latter will be characterized by low losses on cooperative luminescence. Glasses doped with stibium due to the intense and wide luminescence band excited in the ultraviolet region can be used as visualizer of such radiation. And the second, standards for correction luminescence spectra in the near ultraviolet visible and near infrared regions of the spectrum. Glasses cadopin with cerium, terbium, and stibium are suitable for imaging ultraviolet images in medical and biological experiments. And when making a fiber optic screen from them as an X-ray image visualizer. Glasses cadoped with chromium and ytterbium, due to the possibility of increasing their quantum yield of sensitized luminescence and it reducing dependence on temperature, are suitable as luminescence concentration of solar radiation for silicon solar cells with a low lying p-n junction. Thank you for the attention.